up YouTube, Johnny Wad back, here to talk about the Beautiful Monster episode of Killing Me, Season 3, Episode 7. Forgive the noise, it's raining heavily now. Anyways, first, Helene, funny. Villanelle has her in her sights, but she was planning her murder in, I'm guessing that's Helene's house, maybe, I don't know. And, loving a tiny chair. She's such a goddamn child, but I'm here for her. Anyways. Helene, I guess, is gonna die season 4. There's only one episode left. And anyway, hopefully she dies a gruesome, brutal death, but I guess we'll see next year. Okay, Max is the detention center. I had a feeling that Ina was going to be there. I mean, she had dark desires for a while now, so I'm not surprised that she killed her stepdad, because that is her way of getting, vying for Constantine's attention, since being herself, being an intelligent young woman, wasn't working very well, so I guess she decided this is the easiest way to get him to pay attention to her. And, you know, obviously season 1, Villanelle taught her, like, tricks of the assassin trade, and then she asked me, is it hard being bad? And Villanelle said no, it's actually quite easy. She does have a point, because we all could be bad guys pretty easily. We just push in the right direction, we could all become a Villanelle type. But, you know, circumstances would cause people to not be that. So, I mean, Constantine made the right call keeping her in the detention center because she needed help. I guess it was supposed to be 2 days, but I have a feeling it's probably going to be longer since, you know, he had a heart attack at the end. So I'm sure that's going to complicate his plans to get her out. And, excuse me. The golf game. I don't even know what to say about it. That was pretty bad. Anyways. The golf game, Villanelle dressed as the Grinch. She and the Grinch are kind of similar in a way. They're both like monsters who develop a heart of gold, you know? So there was similarities between the two stories, between the Grinch story and V. A few times in this episode they made a comparison, you know? Like, Dasha commented in on her clothes, and then some, I think Helene commented on her, that, coat or whatever she was wearing, so it's been referenced a couple of times, but I don't want to go super deep into it. But the reference is there, so that's sure people know about it. And then Dasha getting hit in the head at the golf club. I'm not surprised. He had it out for her for a while, you know. He didn't want to kill her, but I'm glad she did. Because then we get this nice confrontation, probably in the next episode or sometime next season. They're probably leaning more towards see the finale. No, we'll see Dasha get run through. Her time is almost up. So. Eve finding her, I'm glad Dasha didn't kill her, but I kind of secretly wanted her to crush her. And she was this close, like, I was sure of it. And she was gonna do it. Embracing her shadow a lot this season was something I anticipated for a little bit, but I'm glad she's embracing her shadow. And now she can be a full individual. Same as Villanelle embracing Oksana again. She's like her light. So I'm happy that they're each embracing all aspects of their character and personality. Something that has been going on for a while now. And I'm glad that we are seeing this, because we needed it. You know, Eve needs to embrace her darkness in order to be more relatable, I guess, to Oksana. Oksana's coming through hard and heavy this season, so sure, like, next episode she'll be front and center, I think. But one V, who knows? And that interaction with Constantine, man, you could tell, like, he really wants out. You know, and Constantine wanted out too, but he's having second thoughts about it. Don't they say? They're closing in on him quick. So I'm guessing he, well, actually, I don't have to guess, he was the one who stole the money. And Paul and Carolyn are getting close to finding out that it was him. If Paul doesn't already know. And, you know, it sucks that Mo was killed, but he really didn't do much of anything this season. Like, he only had like a few lines that he actually spoke this season, so his character is kind of a throwaway to me at least. And Rianne doing it, I guess, you know, Helene was, I guess, a test or something, I don't know. It is what it is. I'm sure Carolyn's probably going to be upset about it. I hope, you know, because she doesn't exhibit emotions too often. And this season is the first time we actually saw her exhibit any kind of real human emotion. You know, and then with her smashing her furniture, the way Geraldine is like, you know, want her to do, let some outlet out for her feelings or whatever. I was fine with it. I actually thought she was going to do something even worse than that, but I guess that's a fine way to let off steam. You know? Decent way. And then in the hospital, of course, Dasha would be next to Constantine. So really loves to fuck with Constantine a lot. They really do. And putting Dasha in the sand and bed next to him, you could tell he's really here for a rude awakening. Now I wonder what's gonna happen to him now in the next episode. Is he gonna be discharged, or is he gonna stay there for a while? And then what's gonna happen to Dasha as well? Is she gonna stay in the hospital, or is somebody gonna bail her out? That's just something to think about. But I was really I really did want you to kill Dasha. Her admitting that she she pitchforked Nico, kind of like was setting her off a little bit. I was actually cheering, I guess. Well, not really cheering, I was like kind of giddy. And she was like stepping on Dasha's chest and she was gonna crush, it or something. I would have been okay with it. Really would have, you know. Eve is gonna come into her own and by the end of this season and in the beginning of next season, she's probably gonna start killing a bunch of people. Probably with Villano's help. I think she's gonna like train her a little. Because Oksana's really not going to judge Eve for wanting to kill now, you know? I mean, she did save Villanelle from Raymond last season, and she had to kill him in order to do that. So Eve kind of trusts, they trust each other. So I don't think Eve would do anything to, like, betray that trust. You know, she spent a long time, like, trying to build that trust between them. And if the books are any indication, then Villanelle and Eve are kind of going to get their happily ever after, like whatever the hell that means. Because I know in the book, they do kind of run off together, and Eve was like, did she study psychology or something? And Villanelle, I think it was a... It was something with Russian or something. I don't remember. So, I mean, hopefully they'll follow that route or they'll do maybe something a little bit similar but not as exact as in the books. But I guess we'll find out next season. The next episode, it feels like it's going to be really intense. But, like, where do you go from there? I mean, the person got stabbed, and then, you know, he got stabbed in the first season, then you get shot last season, so, like, what the fuck are they gonna do now? Like, how do you ramp up the intensity? Like, what? Was, like, both of them gonna get shot or stabbed? Like, what the hell's gonna happen now? Like, I'm, like, dreading the possibilities of what's gonna happen. It's like, I really hope that they don't get shot or stabbed or whatever. Like, I want them both to survive. Like, I really don't want either of them to die. Because, like, that would really suck. And plus, if there's going to be a fourth season, it wouldn't make sense for either of them to be killed now. But I really want them to have, like, their happily ever after, at least their version of it. So, yeah, that's it for now, until next Sunday. For any Miami people, like, stay safe out there, because it's been raining really hard for, like, an hour. They kind of just, like, finished work recently, so if you can, don't have to drive, then don't, but if you have to... stay safe out there, you know, just drive slow, and, you know, bring your umbrella and whatever. So, that's it for now. Stay safe out there, you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.